Good morning. So the question we have today is, what do you do about dogs running the fence line or fighting at the fence line with neighbor dogs? It's a really good question. It's super, super common. There's a couple things going on there. If you have neighbors' dogs who are running the fence line or fighting at the fence line, it generally means they're in the yard unmanaged. It generally means that they have a dog who falls into the category of mental masturbation behaviors, which are self-rewarding behaviors with no productive outcome. And it also means that you have a neighbor who just doesn't care enough or is misunderstanding that behavior. Oftentimes we hear that a neighbor will tell one of our clients, "My dog just wants to say hello," and it's most definitely not a hello. So let me show you what we've done. You can work with your dog. Sorry, I've got to step into the dewy morning grass. It's kind of chilly and it feels super good after a super warm week. You can work with your dog of calling them off the fence line. You can work with your dog teaching them to relax on the fence line, especially if you have multiple fence lines with multiple dogs. But it's really time consuming and it pretty much cuts into the time of training. So let me show you what we've done. So we create what's called a dummy fence or an airlock. And I'm going to turn the camera around so you can see it. We oftentimes also refer to it as the DMZ because it's the peacekeeper. So we've created this fence line 3 to 4 feet out from the hard fence. And it creates kind of a dead space where neighbor dogs and our dogs can't go nose to nose. So they can see each other, they can smell each other, but distance creates friends, and distance is pretty awesome. So this dummy fence we put up recently because our neighbor got a new dog, and that'll take about a month for the dogs to settle into each other. And so we have this fence line. And if you use the metal T-posts, and this is just garden welded wire, this is like a garden fencing or snow fencing right here. That's actually super helpful. And then this fence line in back here, we've had that up for about 8 years because that house behind us was a rental for so long and they had dogs coming and going all the time, and that just created conflict and a problem. So if you want to use your yard for training with your dogs, enjoying your dogs, relaxing with your dogs, you have to create a space where your dog also feels safe and where they can hear you and you're not always dealing with conflict. So it's keeping the peace. So if your neighbors decide that they don't want to step up and do the right thing or manage what's in their yard, then it's up to you to do that for your dogs because you are your dog's advocate first and foremost. Have a good day.